Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Faculty, a sabbatical project in collaboration with the Faculty Center for Student Success at Saddleback College. This is a 7-part video series, and today we will cover Part 3, Announcements and Syllabus. These videos are specific to the South Orange County Community College District, but they are designed to help everyone using Blackboard. The Blackboard interface used in these videos is version 9.1. Interface design changes with certain updates, but many of the items covered in these videos have remained constant or been improved with each update. These videos are to help faculty who teach face-to-face classes use Blackboard to enhance their courses. If you are a student looking for Blackboard help, please see Blackboard Basics for Students, linked below. In Part 3, Announcements and Syllabus, we will cover Number 1, Creating Announcements. 2, Setting up announcements and reusing them in future classes. 3, Why you should use the announcement page as your Blackboard homepage. 4, Uploading a syllabus for students to view and download. Number 1, Creating Announcements. Number 2, Setting up announcements and reusing them in future classes. Make sure your edit mode is on and start on the announcement page. Click Create Announcement. Number 1, Announcement Information. This is where you will create your announcement. Start with the subject. I choose a welcome message. And then choose a color. And then type my message. Now that the message is typed, there are a few things I can do to enhance it. First, you should see the editor above your message. This editor allows you to edit your text like you would in a word processing program, and even embed videos and photos. I'm going to keep things basic in this video and show you how to check your spelling and change your font and text size. To check your spelling, click the ABC checkmark. Words that are spelled incorrectly will be underlined. To change your font and text size, highlight your text and then click the font and make your choice. You can preview your announcement by clicking the computer screen looking icon in the right corner of your editor. Number 2, Web Announcement option. In this option, you can pick if your announcement is date restricted or not. I encourage choosing date restricted. This way, if you reuse this announcement in a future class, part 7 of this series, you can control when announcements are visible to students. This also allows you to create multiple announcements at once and decide when they will be visible to your students. To select date restrictions, click the box for display after. And then decide the date and time you want the announcement to be visible for your students. The calendar and clock icon help with this. Then check display until and do the same thing. Under these is the option to email announcement. This option is only available if you make the announcement available right then, not in the future. It is a good way to let students know class is canceled or if you have just graded an assignment. You can always create an announcement and come back and check this box to email it to students if you would like. The email goes to the student email account. Course link. This option lets you create a link to a page in your Blackboard course. If your announcement was about grades, you could link to My Grades. You could browse and then choose your link. Number 4, Submit. Now that you've created your announcement, click Submit. Here is our announcement. You can see the item is not available here, and if you click the edit mode to off, it would not be visible. If you would like to edit an existing announcement, scroll over the subject of the announcement, click the pull-down arrow, and click Edit. From here, you can edit your announcement and then click Submit. I decide to make my announcement visible and change the date here. Number 3, why you should use the announcement page as your Blackboard homepage. In Blackboard, you can choose the homepage students see when they enter your Blackboard course. We covered this in Part 2, Welcome to Blackboard, your first Blackboard shell. The announcement page is a way to instantly communicate with your students when they come to your Blackboard course. It is a place to have the outline for your course that week, a short message about assignments or grades, and a place to post something interesting and relevant in your subject. When a student comes into your Blackboard course, it is like them walking into your face-to-face class. They are ready to learn and have come for your class. Use the announcement page to communicate course-related items to them the minute they come into your Blackboard course. Number 4, upload a syllabus for students to view and download. Now we're going to upload a syllabus to Blackboard. Make sure your edit mode is on. Then we will go to the syllabus link in the navigation menu. Click this link, and you will see a page with no content. Click Build Content, then Item. Number 1, Content Information. I name my item Syllabus with items in parentheses. I have put the content type in parentheses here to keep track of the different content I am building for this video. When building content for my own courses, I would not have this information in the title. In the item, you can place your text from your syllabus directly into the text box, or have your syllabus as an attachment. In addition, you can place a link to a syllabus in the item. Here is the text I type in the text box. I will cover how to add links as a separate content next, but if I have a web link to content, I always try to have a link to it for my students. This way, if students don't have a PDF program or a word processor that works with my files, they will still be able to see the content on the web. I include the URL and also make the URL in the text a link by using the editor feature. I highlight the URL and click the chain icon. That is for insert link. The link path is the URL. I paste this in, change the target to open in new window, blank, create a title for accessibility, and click insert. Here is the link in the text box. Number 2, attachments. To add an attachment, click browse my computer and find the syllabus you would like to upload. You can attach multiple files here. The file name will show up and the link title. I change the link title to Click Here Syllabus PDF. This way, students know to click the link and that the document is a PDF. Number 3, standard option. Just like the announcements, you can decide when students can view the content, track number of views, and select date and time restrictions. As this is the syllabus for the class, I leave all of these as they are so students can see the syllabus as soon as a Blackboard course is available to them. Number 4, submit. Click submit. This is what your syllabus item looks like. Click the edit mode to off to see what your students will see. You can see we created a syllabus item and the attached file is named Click Here Syllabus PDF. Now let's create your syllabus as a link. Make sure your edit mode is on, go to Build Content, and click Web Link. Number 1, Web Link Information. Name your web link. I use the word link in all my web links so students know what they are. Here it is named Link Syllabus Web Link. Then put in your URL. Some faculty create syllabus and class content online. Here I use the URL for a syllabus I created with Google Docs. Number 2, description. Again, I add a little description with directions for students. I type, click link syllabus web link above to view the course syllabus. Number 3, attachments. I could add an attachment here like I did for the item. Number 4, web link options. Open in a new window. I leave this checked as yes. This is an important option because sometimes students may find the files do not open correctly if this option is not checked. Number 5, standard options. Just like the announcements, you could decide when a student can view the content, track number of views, and select date and time restrictions. And number 6, submit. Click submit. Here is what your syllabus link will look like to your students. I use the word link in my titles because sometimes it's not obvious that a link is a link. Blackboard also has a feature under Build Content for Syllabus. In this feature, you can create new syllabus or use existing file. Use existing file will just create an option like we did earlier in this video. If you create new syllabus, you have the option to build a syllabus within the Blackboard framework. Currently, this framework only has three sections, as most syllabi that I see are far more extensive than this framework. I have not seen many people use this feature, but you could use it for syllabus highlights if you wanted to. Using the skills we learned in the video series thus far, I create some syllabus highlights and you can see my results here. If you're going to use this feature, I would still encourage you to have a link to a version of your syllabus that students could print or download. This ensures that all of your students can download a copy of your syllabus. This completes part 3, Announcements and Syllabus. We covered 1. Creating announcements. 2. Setting up announcements and reusing them in future classes. 3. Why you should use the announcement page as your Blackboard homepage. 4. Uploading a syllabus for students to view and download. Our course went from looking like this to this. Thank you so much for joining me for Blackboard Basics for Faculty, using Blackboard to enhance a face-to-face class. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will do my best to get back to you. Please join me for part 4, where we will cover assignments.